Hi, my name is Caitlin Campbell, and I am a student in CIS 220, Technology in Teaching and Learning. This screencast will provide you with information about how to use the Show Hide, Format Painter, and Find Replace tools on Microsoft Office 2008 for Mac. These same three tools are also offered on Microsoft Office 2007 for Windows, and more information on using these tools in Windows is available on my wiki page. So let's begin. Begin by opening a new document in Microsoft Word. I chose to use a document that I have already written in so that it is easier to see what the tools do that I will be teaching you about. To open this document, I will go to File, Open Recent, and click the document that I am looking for. After opening the document, the first tool we will be exploring is the Show Hide button. Show Hide is a tool that is used to indicate when an individual has pressed the return or tab keys on the keyboard, or to indicate when a section break or a page break has been inserted into the document, helping to track when these actions have occurred. This button is located on the top toolbar of Microsoft Word. It looks like a paragraph symbol, and it has the word show beneath it. Here is the button. There are a couple options for using the Show Hide button. The first is to activate the button before you start typing. If you do this, you will be able to see the keys you press as you are typing your document. Another option, which I am going to show you, is to wait until you have finished typing your document and then clicking the Show Hide button, like this, to see all of the paragraphs, indentations, and breaks in your document. As you can see, once I have clicked the Show button, a bunch of blue symbols pop up indicating where I have clicked the return and tab keys or where I have inserted a page break in the document. Here, you can see the paragraph symbols indicating where I've clicked the return key, arrows indicating where I've clicked the tab key, little blue dots in between the words indicating where I've clicked the space bar, and down here, a blue line across the page where there has been a page break inserted. You can also use the Show Hide button to turn the indicators on and off periodically as you type your paper. When you do this, you will be able to track your actions as you type. For instance, on the top of my document, I have an uneven header. The flower, which is supposed to be on the center of the page, is a little to the right of the page. In order to fix this, I am going to hit the tab key, like this, to make the flower head towards the center of the page. As you can see, once I click the tab key, an arrow appears indicating the action. Since each arrow represents one tab that was inserted into the document, using the Show Hide button is useful to help you find when you need to add or delete tabs. This also works for when I hit the spacebar key. Show Hide puts little blue dots, like these down here, in between each word, indicating when you have clicked the spacebar. This is a great way to see if you are missing spaces in between your words or if you have one too many spaces in between your words. By seeing the blue dots, you know when it is necessary to add a space or to remove a space. You can also click the Show Hide button whenever you want, like this, as you are typing your document, to show the actions you have made in your Word document. It is important to note that these Show Hide indicators will not appear when you print your document. whether you have them on, like I do now, or whether you turn them off, like this. For more help with the tab key and to see the show hide button in action, check out Heidi's screencast. And for more information on page breaks, see Jasmine's screencast from the 1030 CIS 220 class. Another tool we will be exploring is the Format Painter. The Format Painter is a quick tool that you can use to change the appearance of text to look like text on other parts of the document. It is located right here on the toolbar at the top of Microsoft Word. It looks like a paintbrush and has the word format beneath it. In order to use the Format Painter, select a word in the document that has a style, whether it is font, color, or size, that you want to mimic on other parts of the document. Click a part of that word, then click the Format Painter button, and then click another word in the document that you want to look like the original word. I chose the word Caitlin because it was in a bigger and fancier font that I wanted to see in other parts of my letter. By using the Format Painter, I was able to mimic the style of my name on another word and also the format. The word dear in this document is now centered and in a bigger and fancier font because I chose to mimic the font and format of the word Caitlin on the top of the document. You can also use the Format Painter to apply a change in text more than once without clicking the button multiple times. To do this, click a word with a style you want to replicate, double-click the Format Painter, and then click on and change more than one word in the document consecutively. In this case, I chose Caitlin again, and as you can see, I clicked the word first, then double-clicked the Format Painter button, and then I could click on other words in the document without clicking the Format Painter button each time I wanted to change a new word. Once you are done using the Format Painter, you can click the button again to turn it off. Another option is to apply the format of an entire paragraph. For example, indents, tabs, line spacing, borders, shading, alignment, bullets and numbering, and anything else that appears under the paragraph group of the formatting palette on the side of your document can be replicated onto a new paragraph. If you want to replicate the features of an entire paragraph, you can use the Format Painter along with the Show Hide tool to highlight an entire paragraph and then replicate it on a new paragraph. To do this, turn on your Show Hide tools and all of your blue indicators pop up on the screen. Find the paragraph with the format that you want to replicate. In this case, I'm going to replicate this paragraph because it is unique in that it is yellow and has a border around it. To highlight the paragraph, I will simply highlight the paragraph symbol at the bottom. This holds all of the formatting of the entire paragraph. Once you have highlighted that, click the formatting palette, click the new paragraph that you wish to change, and as you can see, the format is applied to the new paragraph. Just by taking these few steps, I was able to quickly change the format of this paragraph to match this paragraph with the help of the Format Painter. One more tool that you can use in Microsoft Word is Find Replace. Find Replace allows you to find words in your document as well as change words when necessary. This tool is very helpful when you are searching for something in a multi-page document or you have repeatedly spelled a word wrong and want to change the spelling of all the words at the same time. In order to use the Find Replace tool, click Edit on the top toolbar and then click Find. And once you click Find, a box will pop up titled Find and Replace that asks for various information and has numerous options. In the Find What blank, type in a word that you are looking for in your document. In this case, I searched the word Sundance because it appears many times in my letter and I want to see just how many times it is in there. After typing in a word, like I just did, you can click the Find Next button over and over again, and it will jump around your document until you find the exact part of the document you are looking for. Or you can select the Highlight All Items, setting it to a part of the document you want highlighted, to see where all of the words appear at one time. As you can see, it's highlighted here, and highlighted here. You can also replace words in the document if you have spelled them incorrectly or want to use a different word. To do this, go back to the original Find and Replace screen and click the Replace button at the top of the box. Follow the prompts by putting in the word you are looking to change, like this, Sundance, and then putting in the word you want to replace it with, like this. In this case, I decided to change the word Sundance to Sundance Preschool, so I put these words in the designated spots as shown. From this point, there are various options you can play around with. You can choose to replace only one word or all of the words, or you can narrow your search even further with the options down here at the bottom. Finding and replacing words based on cases, the way they sound, and more. In this case, I'm choosing to replace all the words Sundance with Sundance Preschool. Once you have finished using the Find Replace tool, you will see automatic changes in your document. Here is where the word Sundance used to appear, and now it says Sundance Preschool instead. This is a brief overview on some useful tools on Microsoft Office 2008 for Mac. For more information on Microsoft Office and other programs on the Mac, visit the wiki and check out other screencasts. Thank you.